Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Dan, but we're back with Adventures of Kara the Orphan, Khajiit Orphan. We just camped over at Chordstone, made a little camp right outside the outskirts of the city. They don't allow you to make outskirts within the city grounds or within the village grounds, which is why I had to kind of go off on the side and make a little slopped up little tent here, which was still kind of nice. You know, it was still really good that we were able to get some rest here. Let's go ahead and actually, before we put away though, let me see if we can get some food and get ourselves situated a little bit. So last episode we actually recovered some ore, and right as I was about to sign off the game, I actually went ahead and off camera went back and turned in the ore, since I didn't want to make a run back throughout the recording, throughout the actual adventures. And I actually got some very nice potions from the lady. Very nice, you know, very generous amount of potions from her, because we want to ask her to give us all the draws that she gave us. So we got plenty of draw. We got a draw of health, draw of light feet, lockpicking, defender, the knight, and a bunch of other draws, and some bonuses here and there that the alchemist can provide, which is actually really, really nice of them. And now that we're out here at Chordstone, I believe we can actually explore a couple places that we haven't explored yet. Now that we're all well rested and everything, let's pack up the tent. There we go. All right, in you go. Let's go ahead and head off to adventures. We have a couple of places we want to visit here. I found the shrine that's used for the Dragonborn, but since we aren't a Dragonborn, we can't benefit from it. But I did also find, I'm pretty sure it was a Dwemer ruin around these parts. And Dwemer ruins means we can collect some Dwemer loot. Dwemer loot means we can possibly put, you know, find something that's a really, really expensive out here and benefit from it. Maybe go ahead and loot it. Since I'm out here, I just for the sake of it, we'll have my bow burning out just in case we need to hunt or we need to just inspect the enemies from afar or something. Seems like a very, very lovely morning here over at Chordstone. Very lovely out here. I'm gonna head over to the Dwemer Ruin and see what we can find out there. You know, something we can explore. Looks like some sort of a misty lake over there of some sort. Could investigate that as well. Something's going on there. There's a lot of very ominous mist over there. I don't know if I like that. Don't know if it's safe for us to even approach that area. I mean, look, that looks really, really ominous. Unless it's a hot spring. If it is a hot spring, we could find some Nurnroot near the area. We got what seems to be a soldier or a bandit. It's kind of hard to tell. Not sure if they're walking towards us or not. It doesn't seem like they're approaching us. Seems like some sort of a soldier. Let's see where they go. Looks like they're actually approaching us. They want to talk to us. For the sake of it, I'm going to go ahead and have my mace of burning out just in case. Seems like he's pretty well armored himself. What's going on here?
Are you finished ogling the grotesque? I suppose I should be grateful you didn't simply attack me.
Huh? Your skin. Are you ill?
I am one of the afflicted. I'd have been dead from this plague a year ago if not for Periite's protection.
Where are you going?
Returning to High Rock. Our shepherd lost his way, and I fear Periite's wrath may consume those who remain with him. Kesh could tell you more. I just want out of Skyrim as quickly as possible.
Find Kesh at Periite's shrine. Huh. Interesting. Carry a Periite's shrine. Kesh at Periite Shrine. Where would Kesh be at? Is Periite Shrine anywhere close to here? Let me see. Is that over there? Do I get a clue about it? Nope, that's Branshay, Kyar. What is that over here? Kesh. Wow, the guy traveled a long place to Riften. Huh. Well, the interesting people we meet out here. Good thing I had my weapons out and ready just in case. The guy seemed very armored up, and something's going on with his skin there. Something very ominous is going on there, and I don't think we should be meddling with him personally. I think we should just leave him alone for now. Quick save real quick. What is that over there? Sort of a cage. Oh. Is that a wolf? I think I might be a wolf. I think somebody's actually hunting wolves out here. Well, isn't that interesting? See if maybe we can approach the wolves, see what they look like. Looks like two wolves were actually captured. Well, look at that. Well, look at that. Actually, no, just one wolf, never mind. Just one wolf was given venison. Can we unlock him? I guess we can. Maybe we'd be able to unlock it from the top. I say we just keep the wolf locked up. Somebody needed to keep the wolf locked up, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna keep it locked up. We're not gonna try to pop it open. It looks like there's some sort of a village or a camp. Maybe that's a hunter's camp. I'm gonna go ahead and leave him alone for now. We got our own adventures to actually explore here.
This world is incessantly magnificent.
Oh, it is. It definitely is. What are your thoughts, by the way?
Yes, my friend.
Any thoughts on the place?
No. My mind is a tree without leaves at the moment.
Okay. We need do need to stop by an inn sometime and actually talk to Inigo a little bit, get to know him.
Weapon, my friend. There is killing to be done.
Yeah, I gotcha. One skewer down? You think? Is that it? Inigo? Where'd he go? Is it killing more people? Oh no, there he is. Hey, Inigo! He's running off somewhere. It's okay, calm down. It's okay. We defeated him, it's all good. Guess he's checking the perimeter, trying to be extra careful. That's good. That's always good that he's, you know, checking out and looking out for us. Alright, let's go ahead and head down the hill and see what we can find out here. There gotta be some sort of adventures, you know, some sort of loot that we can nab out here. Particularly in this area, there are no major quest options or any kind of exploration options for us, so we have to go look out for our own adventures out here, trying to find something specific. We do have a couple of Nurnroot that we need to collect for the alchemist, so that's going to be quite a thing for us to deal with, as well as other plans as well. Man, we got actually a lot of carrier-based quests for us to accomplish here. It's going to be a little bit rough. I might have to capture the ones that look pretty easy and the ones that are a little tedious. I might have to do it off-screen or something, just to make our adventures a little more ergonomic, if anything. Let's go up here. Oh, hello. Well, I found a Dwemer location. Some sort of a Dwemer ruin out here. Isn't that interesting? Anyway, let's go ahead and check this out real quick. What I got here? Looks like we can't open it from the outside. Might be able to open it from the inside or something. Looks interesting. Alright, well, we have to try to explore it. I think it's actually over here. Let's follow along the route and see what we can find. Oh, hello. Oh, wait, I know this place. Yeah, I know this place. This place actually cannot be accessed unless we take a particular quest I did as Tamriel some time ago. So we can't access this dungeon yet, but I will go ahead and run over to it and unlock it so we can go back here later if we ever do take on Kaggranar dungeon? Dwemer Ruin? I guess that would be the name for it. Let's head down the hill for now. There is a particular cave I haven't checked out yet, but I think we could probably delve into it and see if we can discover anything specific there. It's getting nice and stormy out here, nice and windy and wintry, so I want to be extra careful. Let's go and get back where it's nice and warm again. Best if we stay within the warm areas. Hello. What is this? Huh. Rovald's Temple. We can't access the Rovald's Temple, but I do hear some wolves out here. I want to be careful. Okay, let's head for that cave that I'm close by to. I'm gonna keep my eye open for the wolves in case they attack me. Let's see, there's a cave out here. Tolvort's cave discovered. Oh, there it is. There we go. Anything up there? At least I don't think so. Looks like there's a cave. Tolvort's cave. I don't know if I've been here before ever. So let's see if we can explore this place a little bit. There's a barrel here, ash yam, grill leeks, that's plenty of food. We currently have a lot of food on ourselves anyway, so I'm not gonna worry about that. Let's head off inside Tolvald's cave and see what we can find. Maybe some sort of riches, maybe a bandit cave, maybe somebody we can raid down. I don't know, take care of a couple of pests in the area. They have a fire. So clearly someone is here. And you go, be careful, buddy. Gotta be quiet. Let's put on a bow of burning. Shh, careful. I don't know if they're here yet. There's definitely somebody here that made a camp and a fire. Let's climb up here and see if we can find some sort of a scout. More food. They have a lot of food on them. Oh. Hello. I think I might know what happened to the adventurers out here. Might have been attacked and eaten by a couple of saber cats. At least I see one. Do we have a potion against... we do have a potion of True Shot. Should probably use that right now and then try to take out the cat. Careful. Careful. Oh, missed. Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. Did we miss? Oh, there it is. There's. Oh, jeez. Good figure now, cat. So running away.
They are no more.
And it's dead. Oh yeah, there's a lot of blood over there. Inigo, stay watch. I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can check out the cat. I think they had the potion of true shot. That's literally what helped us defeat it. Otherwise, the saber cats are really difficult on their own. I have saber cat. I guess we could take him. Not that I need a full quest or anything. So.
People are brought here to die.
Yeah, I can. I get the same feeling as well. Let's not hang around here for too long. Lockpick. Lockpick. I'll take that. Oh, hello. We can open up a chest here. Good thing we found extra lockpicks just for this. More lockpicks, septums, and a war axe. Don't care for that. Buckets, whatever. Alright, Inigo, let's go explore this place a little bit more. See if there's anything other than saber cats here. Lots of traps, I see. A lot of traps. Looks like a hidden door that can be opened from this side. Oh, god. Oh, the traps. I completely forgot that some of them are still active out here. Okay, let's be careful. There's one of the bandits. Boar tusk, those sell for a lot. Lockpicks. We'll leave everything alone for now. Alright, let's be on a lookout. There's clearly some sort of ruins that these bandits explored. Probably got overrun by a saber cat. Yep, a trap got triggered here. Let's go down, see what else we can find, see what else we can explore. I see nothing so far. I sense nothing either. I see spider webs though. Spider webs me. Inigo, Inigo. Good lord, this is terrifying. I think you can see me. I better take a shot and then back away. Back away, back away. Oh god, Inigo, Inigo, help, help. Oh Jesus Christ. I need my shield, I need my shield.
Painful. Are you okay?
I am so glad you were able to help me here. Holy hell. Yeah, we're not gonna take him on. We're not gonna take on Sabertooth Cat again like that. That was a terrible idea. Let's go ahead now. Use a healing potion. Jeez, this was a really, really bad idea. Plenty for healing, that's fine. Use that. And some more potion of healing. Let's not use too many of them. Okay. Gotta be even more careful around these things. Looks like there's gonna be a lot more saber cats here. It tricked me. I thought at first there would be some spiders around here with all the spider webs. Maybe there were spiders here, now there are no more. Maybe the saber cats kind of like took over the area. Yeah, there are two of them here, there gotta be a lot more than I bet. So I have to be even more careful around here. Nothing up there, if some think so. You can harvest a snowberry, I guess. Okay, let's keep advancing forward a little bit, see what else we can find out here. Really cold in here. It's really freezing. Hopefully it doesn't affect our survivability. That's a nice path. Inigo, behind you. Hold still. Hold still. Hold still. Slowly back away. Oh shit!
Did not die graciously.
He did not. I don't know why I decided to hit him with a bow. I was thinking I would either need to smack him with something or do. I didn't know how to counter it. I still don't know how to counter those things to this day. Okay, well, we gotta be more careful. Saber cats and ice wraiths. Good thing our weapons are enchanted at least. That means we'll be able to deal with ice wraiths a lot better. Ice wraiths are magical type creatures, so they'll be most likely affected strongly by magic or by enchanted weapons. Physical weapons won't probably hurt them as much, But good thing we got Inigo here. Good thing. Okay, there's an active torch, which means somebody came through here and lit the place up. Oh jeez, Inigo is going up ahead. Alright, you go ahead, buddy. You go ahead. Oh, hello, coin. I'll take that. Free coin, can't complain. How much we got right now? 5,000? That's pretty solid. That's pretty good. Whoa. Is this safe in here? That's a hidden door. Is that a hidden door? Some sort of hidden door, for sure. Okay, let's see what we can find out here, right? Dwemer pot. Potion of plenty for healing. Ooh, that's gonna be good use for us. Some gold ore, good. Coin purse worth of 30 septums, not bad. Large armor plate metal, I don't think we need that. Door worn shield. Whoa, that's gonna fetch a pretty price. Yeah, we're gonna take that one of those. Ancient Dwemer coins, garnet. Ring of Hunger absorbs health based on level from enemies within 6 feet. Huh. And a little talus. I'll take that. Oh god, Inigo, you better look behind you, buddy.
Two-legged bug.
Jesus Christ. Oh god. Okay, we need to heal. We need to heal real bad. We need to heal real bad. Potion of healing. Yes, please. Oh lord. Oh lord. Back up, back up, back up.
What a stench. My friend, I suggest you breathe through your mouth until this fight is over.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to probably do that. Holy hell. Okay. That was terrifying, to say the least. Oh, Jesus. Bone meal. I don't care for bone meal. Lingering poison. I guess we can take some poison from them. Jeez. Okay, I did not expect this kind of a trap to be here. Former bow. Ebony. I'll take this. Take this. And arrows. I guess we can take arrows. Okay, we gotta be careful. Inigo. You seem to know what you're doing here. We are completely powerless, so I'm gonna help. I'm gonna hope that you can take charge for most of the way through here. Let me just take it nice and easy. Extremely cautious. This doesn't look inviting whatsoever. Careful out here. A bow, alright. I don't see anything. Don't see anyone. Shit, I'm making noise here. Some Skeeper Tail, Frostbite Venom, Big Poison. By venom or X, I don't care for. No, the alchemy lab. I feel like there's something out here. I feel like it might be in the pens. What arrow are we using right now? Steel arrows. Let me see if I can actually switch to a lower grade arrow. Something we don't really care for. Iron arrow. I know in Skyrim, if you bang an arrow against a wall, you can kind of scurry some of the enemies. I wonder if there's something behind this fence. Let me try again. Nothing, okay. At least we might be okay then. Hopefully. Oh, Jesus Christ. What the hell happened here? Hold on, let me turn on night vision for this. Night eye. So many. Jesus! Holy hell, how many people did it kill here? Barrel, chocolate milk, I need that. Oh. We're going here, hold on a sec. There's nothing here, is there? I think it's okay to walk around. I think. Oh, it's Inigo. Okay. God, Inigo scared the hell out of me. That's a hunter. So it looks like these creatures, whatever they are, they started pulling people into the mines then. Alright, well. That's probably a good sign that says we should not be here. We should just leave as soon as we can. What is this way? Is this a way out? Yep, that is. That's probably how they trap people in here. They get, you know, they play it off as if it's a treasure room where hunters and adventurers go in to try to find something, and then they nab them as soon as they get here. Probably just wait until, you know, the poison trap activates and go capture the prey and do whatever the hell they do here. I don't really know, to be honest. I guess we could try to keep exploring further. Gotta be an end to this. An end to this it is. Holy hell. Inigo, you may be able to fight through this, but I don't know if I'll be able to help you out here. Do we want to pick a fight here? We should probably come back when we are stronger, right? I feel like we should. I don't know how big this place is. I feel like it might be kind of big. Especially if they just, you know, snatching people away into here, in Tolvat's cave. Looks like there are a lot of them there. It's like a whole colony or community. Yeah, Inigo, we should probably get out of here. As much as interesting as the place looks, we should probably just. We can come back here later on our way back. Hopefully, better equipped and better prepared. Because I don't think we should be exploring these ruins just yet or these kind of caves. I think this might be a little bit too much for us. Picking our battles smartly, that's what we gotta do. We gotta pick our battles smartly. Maybe see if somebody knows anything about these caves before we come back here again. That would be probably for the best, so let's go ahead and make our way out of here. We probably could explore the rest of the place. It would probably be extremely difficult in order to explore, you know, the rest of it. But
it reeks in
it
here.
certainly does. It reeks of dead bodies. But we should probably avoid this place for now until we learn a little bit more about what we're dealing with here. Because clearly, these creatures, I believe they're called Falmer, are infesting this place, and we probably should not push Kara into. Oh, I guess Karin, I guess not Kara, but Kara. We should probably not push Kara into forcing herself through here. We will, however, leave with some silver ore vein. That's some silver ore we can probably smelt later on in town or something, or sell somewhere. Definitely would be nice to stop by, you know, throughout here and actually smelt it real quick. Or maybe, you know, collect something out of here. Find something out through here, you know? The thing is, it's best if we pick our battles carefully. We're not the strongest adventurer out there, nor are we a capable adventurer. I mean, we are a kid, first and foremost. So we should probably, you know, stay within our limits, our limits of strength. And relying on Inigo throughout this entire battle would probably be a death sentence. I don't think Inigo would be able to even handle all those creatures on his own. They are difficult, they are really tough, and they have expertise in poison, something I have no expertise whatsoever in. So it's best if we try to avoid that particular area for now. Maybe, like I said, come back later. Come back later when we're fully prepared or we're geared up for these kind of like adventures. All right, let's put a point into stamina to make our stamina a little bit easier. Now we got two perks to increase in total. I feel like we should totally increase. What can we increase here? What is this here? Light armor fit as a leaf. Can I be staggered while sprinting if wearing all light armor? You know, that might be kind of nice. That might be actually kind of nice. They've already maxed that out. What can we max out here? One-handed, we should probably max out here so we can do a little bit better. Your training advanced, your fists can be crafted in a forge's unarmed steel. So fist weapons deal. Wow, okay, apparently we can actually get fist weapons if you wanted to. Not bad, not bad. Anything for block we can do? Block mastery, we could do that. Defensive position for 1 second after raising your shield or weapon, blocking 30% more damage and staggering attackers in melee range. If you do not block an attack during this time, you cannot attempt another time block for 2 seconds. Oh, like time a block? That would be kind of cool. Let's go and put a point to that so that it would increase our survivability out here. Definitely be a lot better if we could practice timing our blocks rather than, you know, just blocking every single attack that comes our way. Alright, well, we best get back onto the road or try to find some sort of a highway we can travel against on. The sky's clearing a little bit, but it's still a little, you know, still a little swampy out here. Still, not the most attractive place ever to be. Inigo, help, please. Spiders attacking. Good lord. Okay, careful. Spiders are gonna be. They're gonna try to flank me. They're smart about this, they know strategy. Simple strategy, but still strategy. Get him, Inigo.
Spider.
Got him? Nice, thank you, Inigo. This is why we gotta rely on Inigo. See, he's good at hunting stuff, which is why we need him in this situation. We're not exactly a hunter ourselves. We're just a carrier. What do we got here? I'll take that. That's a Nerut, gonna be needed for our quest here. Let's see if we got some sort of other beast to fight with. Is Inigo on top of it? Is that a skeever? I think it is. Oh, it's a wolf. Oh, well, the wolf died. Okay then, alright, well, look at that. Our little adventure is actually turning up a little bit nicer. That's gonna be a nice boost of confidence, that nice shot right at a wolf. Not even gonna go loot it, I don't even care for it at this point. I'll get it another time. For now though, it just feels nice to know that we're actually progressing a little bit more and on our way to hopefully the right path. Hopefully the right path. Probably should get back on the road or just head downhill or something. And unless we have to fight more wolves. Yeah, we got more wolves to deal with here. This wolf doesn't seem to care for us. Not, never mind. Oh, look at that. Look at that. What a good shot. I like that. Okay, I think we dealt with whatever wolves out here. I guess we should probably just keep on moving forward throughout. Try to avoid most of the ruins out here, if possible. Especially the ones with the flame on it. What is that actually? Some sort of flame. Inigo, let's go check this out over here. See if anybody stopped by here. We got a flame. A tower of some sort. And a mine. Oh, oh, that's a conjurer. Okay, I did not expect that. Okay, careful, careful, careful. Oh, Lord. Get her quickly. Get her quickly. Where'd she go? Where'd she go? Oh, she dead. Inigo, look at you. Good God, conjure familiar. Interesting, we can take that. Oh, my Lord. Inigo, look at you go. Damn, he's good at this.
Yes. Show that orc who's in charge.
I will. I gladly will. Although it kind of makes me feel bad that I think I was actually used as a distraction for that mage so that Inigo could take his killer shot there. Well, I mean, I guess that's the best thing we could do is just, you know, be a minor distraction for whatever opponents we fight out here. What have we got over here? Bleeding crown, some potions. Looks like some sort of another 20 nightshade. Oh, okay, good. Looks like nightshade's something I'm gonna need to collect here then. That's good. Find some of that for a crafting material. Oh yeah, we gotta replenish the stores for the alchemist back in Riften. Oh, that kind of messed up. I guess I should probably try it through here. There we go. Nice little fix. Petty Soul Gem, Septim, Mace of the Breezes, and Mana Alteration. Huh. Dealing with necromancers. I don't know. This tower, I guess, is kind of safe. Maybe we could stay here for a little bit. Yeah, I could probably camp out here for a little bit. It is kind of reaching mid-afternoon, so we should probably take a slight break from our hikes in order to recover. We do have a nice fire, and if any necromancers come out, we can always, you know, fight them, I guess, and just take them out. There's also a little mud crab you can eat if you really wanted to. That's pretty nice. It's actually pretty good. We can have a little bit of critting in the legs. Just enjoy our lovely meal. Yeah, we're probably going to go ahead take a little break here with Inigo and enjoy a little bit of the provisions of the necromancers. We may explore this place since we already know how to deal with necromancers. They are not, you know, foreign territory. They are very weak to physical damage, so arrows will pierce them greatly. Nevertheless, I think I'm going to go ahead and take a little break right here near the fire. Thanks so much for watching. Really hope you enjoy. My name is Stammer. Like, subscribe, and subscribe every day. And I'll see you on the next episode of Kara's Adventures over in Skyrim Special Edition. Anyway, see ya.